One of the most prominent geneticists of the 1900s was Dr. Barbara McClintock. She pioneered a new scientific field and was awarded the Nobel Prize. This is the story of Dr. Barbara McClintock, American geneticist and cytogeneticist. Hello, parent or educator or both. Welcome to Make Them Mainstream. My name is Danielle and I am the founder of Make Them Mainstream. I help people just like you teach young females about science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. Today's Wednesday, so I'm talking about an amazing female in STEM. But every Thursday, I talk about female STEM education or we do a fun STEM activity. Today, we are talking about Dr. Barbara McClintock, and tomorrow, we are going to be talking about the science of corn. So let's see why these two things are connected. From a young age, Barbara was different. She didn't like wearing dresses, she didn't like doing feminine activities, and she didn't care what people thought about her. Her inability to form to the status quo worried her mother, but her father supported her and her desire to go and achieve a scientific education. In order to pursue her curiosity, Barbara attended Cornell University in New York. She would receive all three of her degrees from Cornell, her bachelor's, master's, and PhD in botany. Her first job was as an assistant professor at the University of Missouri. However, she didn't last very long here. She soon realized that because of her gender, the university just wasn't going to give her enough opportunities. She intimidated everyone with her superior intellect. Barbara was always working ahead of her time, and this is why other academics were intimidated by her. However, this also allowed other scientists to kind of sweep Barbara under the rug because they didn't believe in her tactics. Yet. Still, Barbara was able to make great scientific breakthroughs at the University of Missouri. She proved another scientist's theory that there is a link between genetic traits and the exchange of genetic material by chromosomes. And this is what allowed her to pioneer a new scientific field called cytogenetics. In 1941, she received a full-time position at Carnegie Institution in New York. Here, she discovered something remarkable with her research assistant, Harriet Creighton. They were studying corn in order to understand more about genetics. Now, it might seem weird to study corn, but corn is actually a very important scientific tool, and it became incredibly handy for the scientific field of genetics. Barbara was fascinated by corn, especially the corn that had different colored kernels. She wanted to know why each kernel could be a different color. As she and Harriet researched, tested, and experimented on the corn, they came up with their answer. Transposable elements. You can learn more about what all this science means by reading the full article on makethemmainstream.com. Click the link in the description. This discovery was monumental, but other scientists didn't believe her. But Barbara, she didn't care. She just said, when you know you're right, you don't care. 20 years later, other scientists caught on to her brilliance, and that is when she won the Nobel Prize. Some other notable achievements from Dr. Barbara McClintock's life is that she was elected to the National Academy of Sciences. She was the first woman president of Genetic Society of Americas, and she was awarded a Distinguished Service Award by the Carnegie Institution. Dr. Barbara McClintock was an amazing, influential female in science. It's really too bad that we don't learn about more female scientists in school. But wait a second, you can change that. You can bring these stories of women in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics from makethemmainstream.com to your classroom or to your homeschool. We have a whole section on the Make the Mainstream website called the Women in STEM blog, which is all about these biographies or stories of these amazing females in STEM. If you're looking for more STEM activities, then stay tuned for tomorrow's video, where I am going to be talking about the science of corn, and we're going to do a fun STEM activity all related about corn. And yes, it was inspired by Dr. Barbara McClintock. You can bring STEM into your learning environment. Let Make Them Mainstream help you. Share this video with your other teachers or with your other parents so you can do even more fun STEM activities and learn even more about influential females in STEM. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you have an amazing day. Keep being curious, keep discovering, and happy learning.